Sankofa. Sankofa is a can or chi, and it means simply or literally to go back and take or go back and get it. Going back, as in going back into the past, to go retrieve or get lessons, valuable lessons, valuable nuggets that would be used to impact tomorrow.
You've been gone, it's an empty home. Come on back where you really belong. You are always welcome home, welcome home.
Okay, so during this meeting, we were telling everyone to come to the meeting with all their name ideas for the culture show, because we knew we wanted to do something concerning, you know, the concept of home, but we really didn't know where it was, where we're going with that specifically. And so at some point, we're just bouncing off of each other, you know, trying to figure stuff out, but nothing was really like sticking. And then Vanessa just randomly says, oh, what about Sankofa? And we're like, what's that? And so she starts explaining it, and we're just like, yes, like, this is it. Like, it was kind of like an aha moment, and it was like, it was crazy.
But I think that first meeting, we were really just kind of trying to finalize, you know, all right, what is the next month going to look like? Literally from scheduling, like Akir had let us know that we were going to be meeting every week, which I thought was really, really important, because in order to plan a show like this, like, we have to meet frequently. We have to all be on the same page. We have to all provide each other updates on what our respective committees are doing and our progress, just so we're not slacking and people are, you know, all on the same page about what's going on. But then also, I think we were also trying to, you know, get people to sign up, you know, sign up for like fashion show, dance team, talent show, all those different components of the show. We needed people to sign up, and getting people to sign up for stuff is not easy.
I feel like general body meetings are like the real foundation of the organization. That's where you get to meet people, people get acquainted and stuff like that. And our most recent, our last general body meeting, the last one that we've had before all the culture show stuff, was on endogamy, if I do remember. And it's interesting because towards the end of the year, people come less to meetings. It's just the way it is. Like, people get busy. People already got their friend groups and stuff like that. So like, it's like, you know, there's other things to do other than go to a general body meeting. And we've been told that our meetings is kind of late, you know, so maybe they'll change that next year. I don't know.
All right, so if you guys can see the screen, there's a lot of stuff going on this month. Our culture show is going to be April 22nd. That's our biggest. That's our biggest event for the year. Something that we worked towards the whole year. So we got a lot of stuff we got to get done this month. So I want you guys to pay attention to it. So we're gonna be selling food, and we're gonna have it like delivered to you guys. So we're gonna be taking orders for that. And we're start. It says March 12th there, but we're actually gonna start on March 19th. And then we also gonna do an Instagram bingo fundraiser for the culture show as well, which is just basically like, I don't know if you guys have ever seen sororities or fraternities do it, but they got like a bingo card and kind of like a bunch of crazy stuff on there, whether it be about posting, whatever it may be, and then we're gonna like fill that out for the board members. So if you send like $5, $3, you're gonna get to see the board members do something crazy. We're gonna be at Wellness Wednesday.
That just whole Pan-African ideology ties beautifully together with our whole Sankofa idea for the name, being that we want to tell people that they here can use the ASA as an opportunity to return back home and take what's theirs. And that's what Sankofa is all about. That's what the Pan-Africanism is all about, connecting us throughout different cultures. And it was a good way to get into the culture show busyness.
Because I think even it may sound like crazy, because it might be like, what kind of person would be in love with somebody and then just change their mind because their parents don't like it? It happens quite a bit. I mean, like, especially if you're like, I know this isn't my situation, because I've asked explicitly, but I know that, like, especially when you're like the first
son, at least in the African household, it's like when whoever you bring to the house has to be like, in some households, like it has to be a very specific part.
Like I would date someone outside of my culture because I think that it's a beautiful thing to learn somebody else's culture and learn new aspects of life and see things from somebody else's perspective. Yeah, I just think that's a beautiful thing.
But I do miss general body meetings. We haven't had one in a minute just because we've been so busy, but it's still a dope opportunity to prepare for the show, so no complaints over here.
Making the skit for the culture show was a pretty fun experience. I took an acting class the semester before, so I felt a little prepared, but you know, I'm not Denzel or Viola, you know, but it was really fun. It was fun. I got to play a character that, like, you know, just acting in a way that I usually wouldn't act was fun. Some of the acting, I think, was just real.
I think when you introduce Omaha, you should say the O.
I'm saying the O.
So what should
say, Chicago? I don't know.
Omaha.
I actually like that. Okay,
we're talking about. Toughen me up. How tough can you be from Omaha?
Y'all want to know about O?
I'm saying.
Okay, anyways.
Anyways, this is our roommate, Kawaku. Hey.
The whole premise of the skit, it was really just to be like something that we can show during the show. I'll be entertaining, lighthearted, funny, relatable, but not corny and like cheesy. We didn't want to do like the classic like tropes that happen with like African parents and bad accents. We wanted to do something that students would understand and all students could kind of like, I guess, relate to in one way or another.
In that dirty ass dorm you're about to be sleeping in.
And I'm about to be warm and comfortable knowing you're not gonna be there.
Mm-hmm. You're just mad you can't afford your own luxury off campus apartment like I can.
Me, mad.
You're the one who's mad your daddy couldn't buy your way into USC.
You had to settle for what you could afford.
Obviously, as you'll see, it's a pretty cool skit and it definitely made me laugh. So I appreciate them. And thank you for letting me be an actor.
Also, just side note, if y'all haven't told your families about the GoFundMe or friends, you know, please do. We're at $3,150 right now, nice. Which is good. But we can easily hit that.
We can 30, keep going.
We have 39 donations, so like.
So basically, I think I was really stressed about financials and like how we're just gonna pay for the culture show. Like just overall, like some of our fundraising opportunities didn't really go through or like things like that. And we were just struggling with money for a little bit. We even had a GoFundMe. I sent it to my mom, my dad, all my uncles and aunts. She was sending it to everybody she knew. It was just like, we were just stressed and trying to just like scramble for money last minute, yeah.
I feel like one thing that many people don't realize about when you do a show like this is that it costs money, a lot of money. This year the show is over $10,000 in the budget. We really wanted to do it big. We really wanted to up the ante from last year and see if we could, you know, be working towards that, throughout the year and then also throughout the summer. So like, you know, we had our money from last year, and usually our model was really just like getting the money that we make from our events like parties and just pocketing it and saving it so that we can build towards the end of the year event, which is the culture show. So this year it was really like that, you know? We had two parties, both of those we made money from, both of those we saved the money from that. In addition to that, we applied for funding from the university and, you know, like we got some money from, we had money from the university, you know, they gave us like 60% of what we asked for, but they gave 60% of what we asked, what a lot of people asked for this year, just to be as transparent as possible. And, you know, we were way short of our goal going into I want to say like the February period. So we were really looking for ways to make as much money as we could. And that's a lot of pressure to put on like me and our treasurer, Fikayo. And we were just trying to figure out and trying to be, you know, creative with it, whether it be, we had different kinds of fundraisers. We had fundraisers where we did hair care. So we would be like, yo, if you guys win this hair raffle, you know, for $7, you have the chance to get any hairstyle you want. And we did that, you know. We did kind of like a ASA IG bingo thing where like you could pay to get people to do crazy things on their stories. We did that. And we did pie in the face. Everybody loves pie in the face, man.
Culture Show! ASA Culture Show 2023.
April 22nd. Damn.
Two, one.
Hey. Oh.
Too many of y'all came out for that. Too many of y'all hit me too hard. You know, I know, you know exactly who you are. If you're watching this, you know, like, I'm gonna get you back. Like, I'm definitely gonna get you back. But that day was actually kind of crazy because like I was at work and then I came on my lunch break to campus to get pie in the face like 18 times. And then I go into the bathroom, I wash my face, and then I come out and somebody's like, oh no, I just paid, you gotta do it again. I'm like, for real? So, I mean, that was fun though. Like, those are the moments that you ain't never really gonna forget. And we had a lot of fun with that. And we made a good amount of money from that, but we were still short. We made like a GoFundMe, and people really helped us with that and contributed, and that was a huge help to us throughout the process. And the thing is, like, we set really high goals. Those high goals were quite expensive and are quite expensive. We still juggling and dealing with figuring out ways we can stretch the money that we have now. And sometimes I feel like it's unfortunate. I feel like the Black community does deserve more support from the university. I think that hopefully after this event and subsequent events in the future, that we get the attention that we deserve. Like, we get the respect that we deserve. Like, you have students that are putting their own money down in order for things to get done. And with a university like this, where the tuition look like that, you gotta be kidding me. I'm sure there's money laying around somewhere for student initiatives. And we believe the Black student initiatives are very important. So, you know, we continue to invest, we continue to set high hopes and high goals. And the fundraising thing isn't easy, but man, shout out to Fikayo. I'm so glad that me and her were able to work on some ideas, and some of those ideas came to fruition. Some did not, but the ones that did were executed well. And we're just gonna keep pushing, you know? We're always accepting donations, you know? You wanna donate, you watching this right now? Don't let anything stop you, you know? The ASA Cash App and Venmo is open year round. But jokes aside, you know, the goal is to make money so that we can, you know, give back. It's all about giving back, whether it be to local communities through service initiatives or just giving back to the students here who deserve a space to enjoy, celebrate, and make beautiful memories, man. This is college. This is what it's about, you know?
The photo shoot was really fun. It like really matches the theme of what we're going for, and I'm just really excited to see how it turns out, and I know it's gonna look really good.
I must confess, your body very offensive. It is scatter my defense, yo. I must confess, your body not my objective.
I think the photo shoot went well. Like, I did not know how things were gonna go because I was just here looking around. Like, I'm used to this place, but like, I did not expect us to come up with such a cool idea where we had like the couch with all these like banners and stuff, and everyone brought their own props. Everything worked out perfectly fine, well, color coordinated. We did a good job.
I mean,
I'm really glad that all the ideas kind of came to life. I know there's been a lot of talk in our e-board group chat about what we're going to do, where we're going to have it. But luckily, you know, we put all our minds together and really produced something dope. So shout out to, you know, Wengel and everybody for helping out, everybody who brought all the props from home, Abube for using this beautiful space. Everything really turned out well. If not face superiana and your body na palapa, wala, I want it with you ASAP. I must confess, your body very offensive. They scatter my defense, yo. I must confess, your body na my objective. They giving me problems. My darling, would you fly with me? International, you go there with me for flight. Honey, would you stay with me? As I know no man, you go there with me for life. Oh, yeah.
I really like, what's it called again? Because these are everyday activities that we usually do in our house, like playing Mancala or just stuff like that. And it's just like, you know, capturing it and not doing something that is so out there. It's kind of, you know.
Photo shoots are cool because it's like just another form of artistic expression. So Wengel is great. She's done all of our shoots. And it's just cool to see everybody's ideas come together. We're all coming from different, most of us coming from different countries. So using the color coordination with the cloths and everything, the details are up to a T, you know. So I'm just glad that it worked out. I'm glad that we're all in the same place at the same time.
Today's April 1st, and like, it's kind of crazy to think that we're in the same month as the culture show. I mean, we're only 21 days away. So it feels very surreal, but at the same time, I don't know. Yeah, I think I'm just very excited to see, like, all the pieces come together and like kind of see how the show's gonna be.
A lot of different components of the show. We had like Latina really helping a lot with the dance, and Adoba and I have been doing kind of the main things with the fashion show. And we've had like a lot of practices of like marking things out, walking and things like that. Like I have like my notebook that I carry everywhere. And yeah, it's just been a whole thing of like just getting like now down to the nitty gritty. Like I have things like just, you know, sectioning things out, songs, timestamps. We've just been doing that for the big portion of today, because we wanted to like get, I guess, most of the show as we could today so that we could like set things up for later.
We obviously don't have like every part of the show that's going to be actually in the show like ready for today, as in like not everything's going to be in the year.
So that was west, central, east, and south. You're walking in most of the fashion show, please line up here. What's the order again? It's SA with people again.
So
father of the bride usually decides the price. The bride gets confused and go off stage and get the money. Go. Comes back on stage, dramatically carrying money. The crowd is gonna laugh. Put it there. So you open it up a little bit and you look in it.
I'm also going to be in the Central Africa wedding tradition. I think that's going to be really funny. Basically, Cassie's going to be my daughter, and then Danny, he's going to come and try to pay a bride's price, I think that's what it's called, for Cassie. But I'm going to reject him like a few times, and then eventually I'm going to let him like have it. But it's going to be a really funny skit.
There's like little things that we've had to switch this and there, but if I'm being honest, my expectations for the fashion show have been exceeded so much. Like, people walk so well, the songs are like going pretty well. Like, I would say the only thing that would like messed up a little bit was just like picking songs, but honestly everything's been going really well as regards to the fashion show, and I'm like really proud of everyone that's like walking and the clothes we have and the jewelry, because it feels like everyone has that kind of same passion that I do for the specific part of the show, so it's like really nice to have.
Rehearsal today. It was our first one. Well, I feel like it went pretty good for the first one. You know, like, we was able to get what we wanted to get done. We obviously didn't have everybody there, which is a bummer, but I wasn't expecting everybody there because today is kind of a holiday for some people, part of our community. So I wasn't expecting everybody there. I'm just grateful for whoever showed up, and we were able to run through it in its entirety, get everybody just acquainted with the timestamps. You know, that's just what's important. I want people to feel like they understand at least what's going on, you know? When to be quiet, when they can talk, when to laugh, when to clap, all of that type of stuff. So.
Student Organization of the Year goes to a student organization that has made significant contributions to the LMU community by creating a sense of belonging and celebrating and uniting the African diaspora of LMU at LMU through their programming efforts. Please join me in congratulating the Student Organization of the Year, the African Student Association. Congratulations.
We got a standing
We occupy the space.
We said in the beginning of the year, occupying the space.
And we did.
I don't think you saw it.
Maybe we have a culture show too, man.
Right.
Just like,
one day before culture show.
Everything's shaping up.
Good vibes, good energy.
Gotta get to rehearsal, man.
First we have freshman, first year senator, representing Nigeria, Mr. Ebube. Wabuzo, we go put like a clap for him now. I say like I'm buying Tropicana. Me, I don't identify the marijuana. Joanna, Jubadi, Biomogana. Onjo, Omlando, Fumi, Moyagwe, Los Goda. She's gonna be on stage right here, facing this way. So, Stephanie's gonna come on after we perform the keyboards, and they'll perform right there in the front. Their performance is about 7 to 10 minutes.
Ethiopian, Eritrean, Tigrayan, South Sudanese, and then
this is Zulu. So what we can do right now, though, just for the sake of it, we can just count and tell you.
Yes, that'll work, please.
So you think we should do separate mixes for each country?
Yeah, sorry, I mean, like, the songs, yeah, it fades out after West and starts Central, so we know, because, like, it may not transition well.
So for Central, even also for the Igbo, if like the dads or the whole scenario should be happening off stage, because him having to bring all those dads on stage, just walking up the steps, maybe a little bit awkward, it may just be easier for everyone to just be on level, just to walk down.
That's fine.
But he was also saying,
can I have all the Habesha dancers, please?
I'm in the fashion show, so I'm gonna be in the alt section where people are gonna wear like semi-futuristic Y2K clothing. My show is kind of interesting. I wouldn't say it's something that I'd ever wear, like, you know, in public, but, you know, nowadays fashion is, like, you know, kind of weird, so I think I fit that standard. I'm also going to be in the East African, Ethiopian, no, sorry, Eritrean dance. Took me, like, 2 days of practice to learn it. I'm still kind of rusty, but hopefully, you know, I catch my groove, like, once we're actually in the show.
So, be here tomorrow at 2, and, it's gonna be good, guys, it will be good. I promise you, we did a good job preparing, and all that's left is to execute, so, get a good night's rest, see you guys tomorrow at 2, and thank you guys.
Hey, bro. I gotta get up, bro. It's culture show, bro. It's 8 a.m., bro.
Really?
Yeah, you gotta get up, man.
Is it actually 8?
It's 8:09, bro. Well, you're behind.
See that?
We got work to do.
Oh, all right. That was 55 seconds, you know.
Well, your alarm went off an hour ago. Look where you are now. Get up.
Right now it's April 22nd, 1:44 p.m. I'm over here doing mixes for the audio. We got people setting up, and I mean, man, I feel good. I'm just really happy because, like, I came in here expecting the court to not be set up, but people are already working. The work ethic of the Black community here on campus is really encouraging, especially on days like today. People just getting it done. We got things getting set up, and we've really worked hard. Everybody's done their best. So just for that reason, I'm confident, I'm eager, but I'm also willing and ready to, like, slow down and, like, take it all in. This being my last one, and I'm just really encouraged about the kind of people that are gonna be leading this organization afterwards. I think there's a lot to be happy about. I think we're gonna kill it. We're confident, but we're not arrogant. I'm not gonna lie, this shit is very hard to get that game here.
It's okay, I got it. I'll put it on each one.
Okay.
Like, just everybody do, like, put the pipes, the drapes in for me, and then pass it to me, and I'll pull those down.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, so, no, okay. So I remember now. So last year, that's what we did.
Improvements on just, like, timing for, like, what we're gonna go on, like, for dances, because you, like, especially for the East African dances, we're just, like, switching just like that. Once one dance is finished, like, the next week we're on right away. So that's, like, the main thing. But also, aside from, like, the MC might butcher my name, so look forward to that. Like, it's gonna be pretty bad, but hey, hopefully you don't do that.
Right now, like, each moment, I'm really trying to just be calm. Kind of just, you know, take things one at a time. I can't have too many people talking to me at the same time, because it's like I gotta focus in one area and one area, because if I focus on too many areas, I'm gonna get something wrong. But as for right now, you know, people are doing their own thing in there. I'm about to go back to the crib and get some more stuff. I got a little frustrated this morning, so that's what kind of ruined my morning, because just obstacles, like, we always run into those when running this culture show.
Yes, and then you are.
have worked tirelessly to put this show together for you all tonight. Tonight we want to celebrate different regions of the culture. West Africa. West Africa. Give me some for West Africa.
Sankofa, welcome home 2023. I'm just so proud of everybody, bro. Like, the team did not falter. Like, everybody did what they were supposed to do. Everybody did what they were told to do. I'm grateful. And like, it was even hard not to get like emotional at certain points towards the end, because I was just like, this is really the end,
man.
But when you do something right, you're supposed to be sad when you leave. So, you know, now that we said that we leave, we just know we did it right. Yeah. It's that simple.
I mean, you said everything I really gotta say. I think
I keep talking about the beginning, the journey, and now here we are at the end.
Yep.
Part of the journey is not easy. I say my favorite phrase these days, ordeo easy. Ordeo easy just means things are not easy. Nothing comes easy. This did not come easy. We're reaping the reward. I mean, I don't know. This is probably the end of the documentary. You guys have seen everything we've gone through. You guys have seen what it took to get here. I came late. I came 25 minutes late, and I walk in. There's no room. No room. I said, people are coming this early. For us? For LMU, small LMU, just 5 years ago, bro. 3 years ago, I was taking Zoom meetings in the same room as this dude, and that was it. Zoom meetings at ASA. That's it. Now we're in person. Now we're here. Now our presence is felt. Now we're LMU's organization of the year.
Come on.
The student organization of the year. I don't gotta do any more talking.
I mean,
it literally speaks for itself.
Come on.
It speaks for itself.
Come on. Listen, you watching this? You already got the keys. The foundation is built, and it wasn't built alone. Y'all helped us build it. Take your home back, Sankofa.
That's it.
I really want this show to be like a final, like, I love you to the Black community on this campus.